Oh, I didn't even see you guys there. What are you doing here? It's 4 in the afternoon. Well, as you can see, I shaved and I've got my under eye pads on. That can only mean one thing. I'm going on a Halloween date! Duh. What? A makeup tutorial? So there's no one waiting for me? Do you love this? It just came in a Wish order that I got ages ago. I completely forgot about it. It was like a euro or something. It's not as flowy and as fluffy as the photo. It's a little bit... But I love it. I feel like I'm about to open the door to the Gardaí and be like, a dead husband. I didn't hear a thing. Not me joking about having a husband when I can't even hold a boyfriend. So today we're going to be doing a little bit of makeup. In the morning when I wake up.
A moment I wake up. Before I put on my makeup.
I say a little breath for you. That video from Glee lives rent free in my head. Okay, this could be completely fake or it could be real, but I seen this video on TikTok and it was like this person who used flour and Vaseline or petroleum jelly. It's funny, I think the word Vaseline has just surpassed the need for petroleum jelly to even be a word anymore. Like, it's the same in Ireland with like Hoover. Like, no one says vacuum. Even if it isn't a Hoover branded vacuum, people still say Hoover. Like, you do the Hoover, you don't do the vacuuming. Kind of the same as Tipp-X as well. I found out the other day it's called correction paste. Who was gonna tell me? So we're gonna try and recreate that TikTok. So I've got some petroleum jelly, definitely not Vaseline. And we also got some flyer. I'm unable to say flyer without saying it in Nadine's voice.
I enjoy cooking bacon and stuff. Working with flyer.
Working with my hands, working with flyer.
Flyer.
So yeah, let's start with this. Ooh. She's dusty. Okay, so we're gonna mix it in Sean the Shot Glass Skeleton Skull. I can't remember what I called him, but that's him there. That's him there, Nate. So I don't have a spoon either, so I'm just gonna... I feel like this will be a bit of trial and error anyway. That was dumb. That was dumb. This is far too small. So I got something else to mix it in. And if you are Irish, you have one of these in your house, and if you don't, you're lying to yourself. A Voodoo's lunchbox. This is...
Mama, this is garbage.
Oh. Right here.
It's bringing back bad memories of me accidentally having to eat a carrot for what, a rubber or like literally choking down a carrot for like a pear or something stupid.
I can't.
I think this lunchbox probably, oh no. Do you know what? It's all trial and error. It's all a bit of fun.
It's gonna be good and we're all gonna have fun.
And we'll get some petroleum jelly. Now I'm just gonna... And I'll just get my makeup brushes. Do you love the little holder? It's a pot plant from Tiger, which I thought was cute. So I was like, I can put my makeup brushes in that. So I'm mixing this around now. Hopefully you can kind of see. I might need some more Vaseline. Vaseline! It's Vaseline! So I didn't even talk about what we were doing today. So I want to do special effects makeup, but I didn't want to pay for special effects stuff. Now, all I do have is the fake blood, because I know that some people are stuck in lockdown now. Like, literally got word today that it's gonna get pretty bad. So, I'm gonna just dump this out, I'm sorry. Oh, God.
It was a bad idea.
Oh, this was a bad idea. I just gotta keep positive about this, so it'll work out. Like, what is that?
Oh my God, what is that? Oh my God, what is that?
That's not how it looked in the video. I just get these ideas in my head. I'm like, I'll be able to do that, but I'm really not that talented. And that's when you say, no, Chris, you're so talented. Oh my God, look. Look what you did. Look at this. I feel like that's a metaphor for like how my life is going. Like, how are you getting on? I'm like, this is my hand. That's just gone on the ground, hasn't it?
Gonna be ruined. Oh God, that was a lot.
She said it wouldn't stick to your hand.
After it's clumped, roll it into a ball and it should not stick to your hands at all.
It was all a lie. Guys, it was all a lie. She lied.
Okay, so I think I've got it to a nice consistency now after about 20 minutes of trying to roll it around in this. Roll it around on the table. I felt like rolling around on the floor crying, but we're here. Oh my God, I feel like I'm making a pizza. Like, whoop.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
So put her to the side and then we're gonna break out some makeup. I wanna preface this by saying I'm not a makeup guru, I'm not an MUA, I'm not any of that moment. I just have fun with makeup and I think everyone should. I think everyone should just not be afraid to kind of be like, you know, judge. You know, like the wing dialer doesn't look like it's gonna fly off and the cut crease doesn't look like she slashed someone's face. So I think just have a bit of fun with it, have a bit of crack. It's all a bit of banter. And at the end of the day, we're all just here to have a little bit of fun. So that being said, here's some makeup that I have. Now, most of my makeup is pennies. I just think you can't go wrong with this makeup except for buying the wrong shade, which I've done on multiple occasions. That's why I use that kind of like a mixture of all this. I have some makeup palettes. These are from pennies as well. So the ones today are peachy and cherry because we'll be doing some kind of red. Ooh, look at my eyes in the back. We're going to be doing some kind of red look today. And then I also have these. Now, these aren't required, but they're kind of like little face paint palettes. I got these ages ago on Amazon back in the start of lockdown because I thought they were cute. They are cute. They're kind of good, but sometimes I find them they're a little bit waxy. So I think eyeshadow just goes on a little bit easier. So I do have this mirror, which has loads of smudges on it and is showing you my dirty room right now. I'm gonna have this little mirror here to guide me. Basically a primer, I don't really know what it does. I don't really know what a primer does, but you put it on your face before you put on makeup and like it just makes her shine. So I use this primer. Rita Ora is a Rimmel ambassador and I'll never let her down, so. Miss Rita is actually the queen of being sponsored. Like, she does something with JD's. I think she does something with another sports company. Okay, so now we go in with the makeup. This is just a foundation. Now the color I'm using is vanilla. All the really white makeup colors, which is my shade, really white, are so funny. Like they're called like porcelain or like snow, or what else? Vanilla, ivory. I just think that's so funny. So I normally don't do that much of my forehead until the end because I have these frown lines. Frown line, Maria.
How do you solve a problem like Maria?
Like literally look like Wi-Fi signal. So basically I leave that till the end because I'm like, then I'll get as much wear out of the makeup as I can. The biggest dead giveaway of you've been wearing makeup for a long time is any creases in the makeup. And here the makeup just collects, like it just goes. I try to leave that as bare as possible to the last second. I actually remember going on a night out in Sydney and we were drinking and I did my makeup and then I was like, I'm leaving my forehead till like the second we leave, okay? So when the Uber comes, let me know and we'll get into it. And I'll just do my forehead either in the Uber or I'll do it just before we leave. And my friends were like, yeah, it sounds good, blah, blah, blah. So we're all drinking, we're having fun. Then the Uber gets there and we're like, okay, we have to go. And then I was like, yeah, perfect, okay. And then I was like, I'm forgetting something. And I was like, oh, the keys. So I grabbed my keys and we left. And long story short, well, to be honest, it's a short story anyway. So short story short, I forgot to do my forehead. And I think there's pictures of me. And if I can find them, I'll put them up. If I can't, I'm sorry. But you'll just have to use your imagination. Basically with like creamy ass face here and then just red. Like a forehead. Because, oh my God, trademark that. Hashtag forehead. Basically, the reason I had a red forehead is because I kept getting sunburned. No matter how much sunscreen I put on. I just burn so easily. And then I burn by Ellie Goulding. And we're gonna let it burn. So now I'm going to move on to my eyes and I'm going to use my little cherry palette. Get the doll head back in. Oh, let me knock everything over first. We should give her a name. Do you know what name I'm going to give her? Cynthia. Do you remember Cynthia from the Rugrats? Cynthia, So I'm just going to try and do my eyes. Now again, I'm really bad at makeup so I can't do the eyes that well. I'm not doing a cut crease. I'm just doing red. I want to see your eyes glow red. Red. Yeah. So that's what it is. It is what it is.
It is what it is.
Now I'm actually not going to go in with lipstick because I think this will look better with like a more natural color lip. So I'm using this. So it's like it's called a lip butter because it's going to look a little bit natural. Just like my eyes.
You cannot be for real.
Oh my God, I'm like a celebrity. Oh my God. I could walk the red carpet in this. They'd be like, Chris, who are you wearing? And I'm like, oh my God, stop. It's Tesco and Wish. Wish where? So now we're gonna get to play with our thing.
Wait a damn minute.
Okay, wait, rephrase that. Now we get to play with our Vaseline special effects makeup. Okay, let's see. I'm just gonna like, oh, it doesn't stick to my face. Why is it not sticking? What's not sticking?
It's not clicking. What's not clicking?
Now, just a warning, okay? If you are squeamish or any of that stuff. I don't know what the other words are. If you're squeamish or scared of blood, or like gore, this might look, and you know what, you can probably still watch because it's not going to look that real at all, I'd imagine, but that's just your little warning that like it might look somewhat real and I don't want anyone to squeal. Okay, so now what you want to do is go in with something kind of really skinny.
Me. So you think I'm skinny?
JK. Not JK. If you could get something that's really kind of pointy, and try and draw a little line. So I'm using the back of this paintbrush that I have. And try and just give a gash. So basically, get your mind out of the gutter. Don't get in my eye, please. I think we'll go in with like a black, oh my god, I pushed them into my eye out. So yeah, this is like the winged eyeliner look, but it's blood. So next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get one of our skinny makeup brushes and kind of go in to the crease with the black and just slowly fill that up. Cause I feel like that's gonna give it depth. So it's just gonna make it look like the wound is a lot bigger than it is. It's starting to come together. So you just want to go in gently and kind of go over where the Vaseline is. But basically what we're trying to do is make it look like it's bruised or it's hurting. A nice other color to use would be like a purpley color. The bruising would be a bit more purple. So I'm just gonna go in a little bit with that. So I'm gonna leave it like that and we're gonna go in with the fake blood at the end. So I have another thing that I want to do, which is to do a smile on my face. So this is gonna be cool. So what you wanna do is just roll it out again. This isn't a tutorial by any means, even though I've been kind of giving step by steps. You know, just, it's more like with makeup, I think you should play around with it a little bit more. Like there's too much focus on kind of trying to recreate someone else's look. Like you might decide you want a scar going down from your eye, or that you want something coming down here. Like do it, just do it, whatever you think. You're gonna be the best judgment of it. So again, now I won't be able to talk a huge amount. What a time to be alive. I'm gonna be talking like this. So the reason I went with the natural lip color is because I wanted it to look like this just happened to me rather than like it was a makeup look. Oh, get back up, come on girl. Can she stick the landing? No, she can't, oh my God. You're going home with silver. Okay, that bit's on, but she's a little thick.
Girl, you're thicker than a bowl of oatmeal.
I think we're all a little thick, so. Okay, so that's done. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do with this one, I'm gonna put makeup over this a little tiny bit. Hopefully it won't stick to the sponge because I just want it to look a little bit more like it's part of my face. Oh no, it all came off. All right, this side of the face is not playing.
Oh, I don't want to play any more games.
This is looking a lot better, guys.
Cause it's, bitch, is you black?
Okay, that's all done. So now what I need to do is get the black again. And then just go and do the black line. Thank God I did the eyes first. Imagine if I did this first. And then I had to do the eyes. I'm like, oh yeah, and then we want to do the eyes. Now, they're a little bit uneven. But I think that's part of the fun. Because, first of all, I don't think...
Are you kidding me?
First of all, I don't think I'd be able to make them even. And second of all, like, it's supposed to be look like someone just sliced your face. Or you did it, like, because you're psychotic or manic. Or just stuck in lockdown. Please don't slice up your face. Just get some Vaseline and some flyer. And then what you want to do is also do a bit around your lips. Oh, that's looking cool. I think I need therapy.
You need a lot of psychological evaluations.
I can't forget that I still have to do my forehead. So... someone has to remind me. Ew, I don't want to accidentally eat it. Eat it! Oh, cute! Cutie alert.
Hey, cutie!
Oh my God, I couldn't find the fake blood and I was like, that would have been the look ruined. And just kind of go in with it. Oh, that's sick. Oh my God. That's so cool. Oh my God, how gory is that? Not gory Wexford, gory as in gory and gore. Now you can kind of bring it down a little bit to make it look like she's bleeding. This is looking wonderful, spooktastic. You can mix a little bit up around the wing just to look like it's been like slashed open, that the blood splattered a little bit. Okay, and now we're going on to the eyes. So we'll start with this one. And then I don't know how to do it with that hand. Okay, let's try this. The right hand, she's not as strong as the left. Damn. How sickening does that look? Sickening, no?
Sickening, no?
I kind of wish I did my eyebrows properly beforehand, but I'm going to do them there really quick. And through the magic of editing, they'll be done right before your eyes. I didn't really do them. I just did a tiny bit. Now, I might do a little bit of blood under the eyes to make it look like I'm... I might do a little bit of blood under the eyes just to make it look like I was crying blood. That might be too much, but sure luck. It's done now. I'm obsessed. You don't understand. I am obsessed with this.
No, I don't think you understand. I'm obsessed.
I really want to do like a handprint like that there, but I'm going to ruin this t-shirt, which I don't want to do. And I'll do it. That looks amazing. I can't laugh because I'm going to ruin the makeup. Oh, that looks cool. Does it? Or does it look a bit messy? It looks a bit messy, but kind of cool. I can't really see. No, that does not look cute at all. I think I ruined it there, but sure look. And then that's it. It looks amazing. So in true, I'm a YouTube makeup guru now. I'll do a little photo shoot for you guys just for Halloween. So it's all cleaned up and we're all ready to go, but then I forgot. Well, you guys forgot and I'm blaming you. You right there. My forehead. Hello, my forehead. So we're just going to do that really quick. And I put away the mirror, so we're just doing this in the viewfinder.
Ooh,
I feel like there won't be much attention on the forehead now anyway, hopefully. I'm going to do what this look was intended to do, and that's to scare people. So let's see how my family react.
What do you think?
How long did I take it? Let's go. Okay. 2 hours. Oh, that is sickening.
What do you think they were? Oh my god. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, that's very good.
What do you think,
Dan? Video, you know. Oh my god. You think that was fucking real?
I wasn't expecting some reactions and I was expecting others. Anyway, on with the photo shoot. As you can see, I changed outfit halfway through that little photo shoot. And I found this as well, but it doesn't fit because my neck is too big. The neck! And it's also melting off my face. So, thank you so much for watching, everyone. And for anyone who was scared of the look, I'm glad it scared you. But you have to remember, it's all just fake, like me. So... also, I forgot to say, please like and subscribe. Should have done that before. I started all this, but plenty more days to come. I'm gonna have to go Irish for this salon.